Hey, beautiful people. In my last video, I kind of talked about how along with Replit's Agent 3, they also release an AI bot building tool that lets you build your own custom AI agents in Telegram or Slack, lets you set up automation chains. This lets me talk with ChatGPT on my phone and Telegram and plan all my meals for the week, do all the shopping, custom recipes. So super easy to set up. And so I realized this just needs its own video. Up front, I had one problem with deploying this bot at the end, but I was able to troubleshoot it with Agent super easily. And I believe Replit has kind of patched this and made it a lot smoother. It's so sick. I think you guys could build a lot of cool custom bots for this. Use them for yourself, sell them to businesses. It's easier than ever to create custom AI bots thanks to Replit. Let me know in the comments what kind of bot you're thinking of building, what you would build with this. So yeah, let's get right into it.
All right, so maybe while we let autonomous mode do its thing, we can explore agents real quick. What do we want? Select the trigger event for your agent, Slack message, Telegram message, time-based. And what do we want this agent to do? Oh, let's just make one that plans like my meals for the week. Build me an agent that can create a weekly meal plan for me for each week for meals for dinner and lunch and give me a shopping list and estimated price of the items on the shopping list. And I can tell it, you know, how many I'm cooking for that week, how many lunches, how many dinners. Any things to avoid, any like things to include, or if I'm like wanting like high protein or what.
Okay.
This would actually be sick. I actually haven't connected it to Telegram yet, so this will be good to try out. Let's see. I logged and I'm logged out of Telegram.
Okay,
cool. Logged into Telegram now. Okay, cool. This is going to be sick. It's asking me for my OpenAI key for this agent. Meal Maestro. It's a good name. Okay, so we spent 20 cents so far on developing this bot.
Okay, yeah. And so you can just test your agent here rather than having to go into Telegram to test it each time. So that's super cool. And see how it has these tools created for me? That do different things. That's pretty sweet.
Okay, set up the original version of this for $2.82, which I think is pretty great. And now we're here. So I tested it and I had it change a couple tool calls because it was running to errors, but it was working pretty great. We spent 37 cents on editing that. And we're not using max autonomy. Oh, I'm such a fool. But anyway, hello. I need a meal plan for two this week. So let's test this new automation. Two lunches, three dinners, no dietary restrictions. Let's include chicken and avoid any fish besides salmon. Let's make quick recipes that we can have leftovers for. Okay, so it's thinking, it's using my OpenAI credentials to do this. It's gonna call these tools, meal planning tool, shopping list tool, price estimation tool. And then it should bring all this in for me. I can't overstate how nice it is to have this UI to test the agent in versus having to like switch between like your phone and test it in Telegram or Slack. Like I think this is really nice for testing agents and then just porting them to where they're going to be published to. Okay, so this is taking an interesting amount of time. The agent's been stuck thinking for like a minute after I answered, could you please provide a bit more information question? Can you figure out why? So we need to debug. Okay. And it fixed our Telegram bot. So let's start this from scratch. Hi, I need a meal plan. Two people, three lunches, four dinners. No dietary restrictions. Include high protein food. Avoid any fish that's not salmon. We like Italian food and we like quick meals with lots of leftovers. Turn on stream and just see what happens. Don't know what this is. Replit Agent 3 automations. I don't see it here in the docs. But I do recommend, like, if you guys are looking through these new features, definitely come to the docs if you have questions. All right, so it's using the meal planning tool and the shopping list tool. This is sick. Okay, I think this makes sense. I mean, like, they're definitely encouraging you to make this more complex because, right, this is super simple. We don't need, like, a diagram for this, but you could see how you could add in multiple cool tools and, like, branches and different kinds of agents and make really complex workflows. I think the next thing I would want to do is maybe like generating ad creatives. So like maybe paste in or like scrape like some competitor ads that I like, and then have this generate a bunch of like the creative assets as well as like all the text we would need. That would be sweet. Main chicken salad, caprese, quinoa bowl, salmon and spinach wrap, mixed greens, cherry tomatoes, basil leaves, bell pepper. Price estimate, $59. There's no way this is $59. Okay, maybe it is $59. I'm kind of running the math. I mean, salmon and chicken, I feel like that's going to be like at least $20. Maybe it's assuming you have some of this. Interesting. Well, that's pretty cool. So the next step I think would be to publish this. So let's add it to Telegram. Okay. In Telegram, search for Botfather. Botfather. Okay, I've got Botfather. Clicking start. Click new bot. Okay. Meal Maestro is going to be the name. Okay. Congrats on your new bot. You can now add. Put this token in a note. Let's go to notes. Let's go here. Bang. Continue. Publish. All right. It's publishing. Okay. Search for your agent in Telegram using the username you set. Okay. My Meal Maestro. Oh, okay. So I found the bot. Start. I need a meal plan for this week. Oh, do I need to add the bot? Go check the docs. Your agent must be deployed to function with external triggers. The testing pane works for development testing, but live triggers require deployment. I messaged the bot on Telegram. I don't get a response. I've tried doing /start, and I've tried just saying I need a meal plan. Is there something I need to say to trigger it, or what's going wrong here? Can you please debug? Okay, so that's interesting that it's not messaging back, but it could be because we just published it, but it says it should be out there. You click view publishing options. Telegram. Figure the webhook. Did we not publish it correctly? I think I must have done something wrong here. I mean, should we try and just create another one again? Can edit the bot. Can add commands. Hopefully, we can get him to work. Yeah, I just messaged it again and didn't get anything. Message the bot on Telegram again and didn't get a response. Can you help me get it to work? Maybe we need a command like /start to start the bot. Hopefully we can get this working because, I mean, this would be huge, like, if you can just create bots this easily. They're super useful for your own personal workflow. And I know there's a ton of money in creating bots for people. And this is so easy. Like, I didn't have to open a code base, install a bunch of packages, like, create a developer account. Like, I didn't have to do any of those annoying things that come with creating software like in a closed ecosystem. And I know that Telegram's like developer friendly, and that I think with Slack there'll probably be more steps, but I'll make a video on building a Slack bot. But I mean, this is crazy. Let's get this thing working. Let me check the latest logs. When you message a bot on Telegram, no logs are generated, but between some messages, the deployment message from Telegram. Did I do something wrong during setup? Shoot. Yeah, I thought it would be in secrets. Okay, guys, we got this bot working. I just kind of sent a prompt and said, hey, I've already entered this Telegram API key and it's not working. Please troubleshoot. And it troubleshot. So it sent me like those questions about the meal prep. I'm going to answer them. Okay. I think this log is for the dev app. So I guess I'm going to wait because it takes a second. I guess that's one of the annoying things I didn't think about is how can we actually like live debug something that's on Telegram? I wonder if flipping this stream thing changed anything. Oh, logs. Let's see. So if you've published, come to the publish tab and go to logs to see what's going on in your app. Okay. We have a bunch of errors in the logs. Maybe I can try starting over. Start and see what happens. Okay. Oh, so if I just say start each time, it'll go on to the next task. So I guess that's, I don't know why it works like that, but yeah, you can see I got my meal plan list. And a list of ingredients. Salmon piccata. That's sweet. Okay. Well, this one definitely needs a little more tweaking, but I'm pretty impressed with where we got. So we showed you building a simple web app with Agent 3 and building a Telegram bot with Agent 3. But my thoughts are I'm blown away with how easy it is to set up a bot automation workflow in Telegram. This is really cool. This is super powerful. You guys should definitely play around with this because I think it can add a lot of value to your own workflows or other businesses' workflows. And you could make money helping people set up Telegram bots with Replit. Manage them all in one place. be nice and easy. All right, guys, that was our custom Telegram bot in Replit. You could build one in Slack. You could build one that you just embed in your website. The possibilities are endless. I'm excited to see what you guys do with this. I'm excited to play with it more myself. Make sure you go give Replit a try. Use code Billy to get 12% off. And yeah, let me know what you're thinking about cooking up, what you want to see me do next. And I look forward to the next video next week. I'm trying to do every Tuesday. Turn those bell notifications on. Hype the video, like the video, share it. Really helps me out here. Peace.